Hello friends and welcome again to our channel, The Teacher. In this Excel 2016 tutorial video, we are going to learn about how to insert, rename, copy, move, delete, hide and unhide Excel worksheets. In Excel 2016, when you open a new file or a new workbook, by default, you get one worksheet labeled as Sheet 1. Whereas in previous versions of Excel, the default worksheet numbers were 3 for each new workbook. First of all, why would you need to insert more worksheets into a single workbook? Let's see an example of this workbook where several worksheets have been used into a single workbook. As this is my YouTube analytics report, I would love to manage different months' data on a single workbook rather than creating separate workbooks or files for each month. So whenever I need to work with analytics report, I can open a single workbook and can easily switch between different worksheets instead of opening separate workbooks for each month, which really saves you on managing a large number of files for a single related work. Now let's learn how you can insert and manage multiple worksheets in a single workbook. To insert a new worksheet, click the plus new sheet icon available at worksheet bar and in an instant you will have a new worksheet to work with. Keep in mind that the new worksheet will get inserted next to your current selected worksheet. If you are currently working on the last worksheet, then the new worksheet will get inserted next to it. But if you want to insert a new worksheet, let's say between the month of April and June, then you can first select April month worksheet and can then click Insert New Worksheet plus sign button and a new worksheet will get inserted right to your current selected worksheet. You can also insert a new worksheet by clicking on the Insert drop-down menu from the Home tab and then click Insert Sheet. Another way of inserting a new worksheet is to right-click on one of the Sheet tab and then choose Insert. And then you can either choose to insert a blank workbook or can have a ready-made template from the list. The only difference inserting a worksheet using this method is the new worksheet gets inserted to the left of your current selected worksheet, whereas in previous method, the new worksheet gets inserted to the right of your current worksheet. Even if you insert a new worksheet at a wrong place, then you can easily move worksheets at the desired position by just dragging and dropping them from the sheet tabs. You can reposition any of your worksheet anytime by just dragging them to the desired location. But let's say that there are many worksheets inside a workbook and you want to quickly move the sheet number 3 to the end of this workbook, or let's say between sheet number 49 and 50. Then another way of quickly moving a worksheet is by right clicking on the worksheet tab and then click move or copy from the context menu. If you want to move the current worksheet to the end, then just select move to end and hit the OK button. Or you can select sheet number 50 and this sheet then will be moved right to the sheet number 50. Copying and duplicating a worksheet could be very much helpful to you when you need the entire layout and formula of the current worksheet inside a new worksheet. For instance, here I have a worksheet of detail marks of 5th standard. Now I need to create a new worksheet for 6th standard class, where all the layout and formulas will be same as they are for the 5th standard. The student names and obtained marks will be changed. So what I can do here is, I can create a duplicate of this worksheet by holding down the Ctrl key and dragging 5th standard sheet tab to a new location. You will see a plus sign will appear as you will hold down the Ctrl key while dragging and dropping the sheet tab. This is the quickest method of copying a worksheet. By copying a worksheet, I can easily fill the data of 6 standard students, whereas now I don't need to start over everything from scratch, like designing, setting the layout and entering the formula again for the 6 standard students. So duplicating a worksheet can really save you on time when you only need to change specific information and rest of the worksheet layout and formulas will remain the same. Another way that you can use to copy a worksheet is either by right-clicking on the Worksheet tab and then click Move or Copy, or you can click the Format drop-down menu from the Home tab and then click Move or Copy Sheet. And this time make a check mark on Create a Copy and tell the position where you would like to place the duplicate copy of the current sheet under Before Sheet section. When you have multiple worksheets inside a workbook, then it is very much important to name your worksheets so they can be easily identified and you don't waste time searching for particular contents. To rename a worksheet, just double-click on the Sheet tab that you wish to rename. As the cursor is now inside the tab, you can delete and type a new name for your worksheet and then hit the Enter key. Another way of renaming a worksheet is by right-clicking on the Sheet tab and then choose Rename from the context menu. Or you can also use the same command through Format drop-down menu of Home tab. Now let's talk about deleting a worksheet. Certain times you might like to delete a worksheet that you no longer need. But before I tell you the procedure of deleting a worksheet, keep in mind that certain worksheet commands cannot be undone and deleting a worksheet is one of them. I mean, if you delete a worksheet by mistake, then you cannot use undo command to recover it. It is gone for good. So it is important for you to keep this in mind that worksheets are always get deleted permanently. You can delete a worksheet by right-clicking on the Sheet tab and then click Delete from the context menu. You will be warned that Excel will delete the sheet permanently, and if you are okay with that, then click the Delete button. The only way of recovering a deleted worksheet is by not saving the workbook. For instance, let's say that I saved the workbook before deleting a worksheet, and after deleting the worksheet, I realized that it was a mistake. What I can do now to recover the worksheet is, I can close the workbook without saving it. It could be a nice trick to recover a deleted sheet, but also remember that all the unsaved information will be lost. If you delete a blank and untouched worksheet, then it will get deleted without notification. You can also access the Delete Sheet command from the Delete drop-down menu of Home tab. For easy identification, you can also use Sheet tab's color. If you have several worksheets inside a workbook and are being categorized, then you can use different tab colors or for different categories to easily identify them. Certain times, you might also like to hide a worksheet that you think should be kept secret. To hide particular worksheet, right-click on the Sheet tab and then click Hide from the context menu. You can also use Hide Sheet command from Format drop-down menu by pointing to Hide Unhide section and then click Hide Sheet. To retrieve back the hidden worksheets, you can either right-click on any Sheet tab and choose Unhide, or you can open the Format drop-down menu and then click Unhide Sheet from the Visibility section. Then you will be presented with a list of hidden worksheets and you can choose which one you like to unhide. One important note, hidden worksheets do not get print, even if you use the print entire workbook command. To exclude a few worksheets when you need to print an entire workbook, you can hide those particular worksheets. So, this was all about managing multiple worksheets, and I hope you will find this video informative. Tell us by leaving a comment and like, and by sharing this video with your friends. Subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks for watching and take care.